Given the rational function, we want to determine the domain of the function, complete a table of values, and then graph the function. To find the domain of a rational function, we want to find which x values we must exclude from the domain. And since division by 0 is undefined, we want to find the x values that make the denominator equal to 0. So we'll set the denominator equal to 0 and solve for x. But before we do this, it's always helpful to have a rational function in factored form. So we're going to factor both the numerator and denominator. So if these do factor, they'll factor into two binomial factors. So for the numerator, the first terms of the factors would be x and x. And now we want the factors of negative 3 that add the negative 2. That would be negative 3 and positive 1. And then for the denominator, we'd have x and x. And then we want to find the factors of negative 6 that add to negative 1, which would be negative 3 and positive 2. Notice how this rational function would simplify, but we don't want to do this until after we determine the domain. Looking at the denominator, notice that if x is equal to positive 3, or x equals negative 2, the denominator would be 0, which means we'd have division by 0. Therefore, these values must be excluded from the domain. So the domain is all real numbers except x equals 3 and negative 2. So we can say all reals, we can use this symbol for real numbers, except x equals 3 and negative 2. And then going back to the factored form of the function, because 3 is a 0 of the denominator and the numerator, because of this common factor, we don't have a vertical asymptote at x equals 3. We have a hole in the function at x equals 3. So let's record that. We have a hole at x equals 3. Now that we know this, we can simplify our function here and here. That simplifies to 1. And since x equals negative 2 is a 0 of the denominator, but not the numerator, we have a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2, which should be this vertical line here. Remember, a vertical asymptote is a line the graph approaches but does not cross. So now we can actually complete our table of values using the simplified function as long as we remember we have a hole at x equals 3. So what we'll do now is use the x value where the vertical asymptote is at x equals negative 2 and place this right in the middle of the table. And then we'll pick values that are greater than negative 2 here and less than negative 2 here. And we do want to know how the function behaves close to the vertical asymptote. So for the first value greater than negative 2, we'll select negative 1.5. And then for a value less than negative 2, we'll select negative 2.5. And then next we'll use negative 1 and 0. And then for below, we'll use negative 3 and negative 4. We already know at x equals negative 2, the function is undefined. And now to help complete this table, we're going to use the graphing calculator. So first we'll type in the simplified function. Before we grow the table, let's take a look at the graph on the calculator. For the standard window, we'll press zoom 6. You can see that we have one vertical asymptote. The hole does not show on the graph for two reasons. First, we're graphing the simplified function, which doesn't show the hole. But even if we graph the original, because of the number of pixels on the screen, it wouldn't show. Now to set up the table, we'll press second window. Let's start at negative 4. And then we'll have the change of table be 0.5 because of our decimals in the table. We want independent to be on automatic, which it is, so we'll press second graph. And now we can find all the values we need to complete our table of values. Of course, we could perform the substitution by hand, but this is a big time saver. So starting at x equals negative 4, notice that y is 1.5. At negative 3, y is equal to 2. And at negative 2.5, y is equal to 3. So we have 1.5, 2, and 3. Notice at negative 2 we have an error because that's not in the domain of the function. At negative 1.5 we have negative 1, At negative 1 we have 0, and at 0 we have 0.5, which would be the y-intercept. Let's go ahead and plot these 6 points and see if we have enough information. So 0 comma 0.5 would be the y-intercept here. Negative 1, 0 is here. Negative 1.5, negative 1 would be here. And then we have negative 2.53, negative 3, 2, and negative 4, 1.5. Now there's one more thing we should discuss before making a graph of this function. It also has a horizontal asymptote. To determine the horizontal asymptote, we want to see what y value the function approaches as it moves to the right or moves to the left, meaning what happens to the function value as x increases or x decreases. A nice way to see what's happening is to use the table feature on the graphing calculator. So we'll scroll down to see what happens to the value of y as x increases. Notice that y is increasing, but it's actually approaching positive 1, which means y equals 1 is a horizontal asymptote. And the same thing is true as x decreases on the other side of negative 2. Notice the y value again is approaching positive 1. So we have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1, which again is very helpful to sketch a nice graph of the function. Another way to determine this horizontal asymptote is, notice that the degree of the numerator and the degree of the denominator are the same, so the horizontal asymptote will be the ratio of the leading coefficients. Since 1 over 1 is equal to 1, y equals 1 is the horizontal asymptote. So now we'll go ahead and sketch the graph. Again, it's going to approach this vertical asymptote and horizontal asymptote. But remember, we have a hole at x equals 3. So we'll pause here and make a hole, and then continue our graph. And then for the piece on the left, passes through these 3 points, approaching the asymptotes. And again, the equation to this vertical asymptote was x equals negative 2. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.